at Hsinchu. I mean, I feel the people are so friendly and the space is extremely scenic and spacious. And let's not even talk about the food. I mean, I love the food. It just appeals to my palate. I'll definitely come and visit this place again.
A lot of people think of Hsinchu. They only think of the industrial park, or they think of maybe the meat, and you know, the rice noodles, the vermicelli noodles. But to me, I don't know. Hsinchu actually has a lot of things that are really fun. There's a lot of activities that you can do here. It's a really fun part of the country that a lot of people don't know. Upon reaching this northern region, it's easy to see why the city here bears the nickname Fengcheng, or the Windy City. Indeed, it's this temperate climate, together with the land itself, that has allowed this region to prosper. From the early Aboriginal settlers who discovered the region to be a plentiful source of bamboo, to subsequent generations who have harnessed the most basic of elements to produce commercial goods and power, Hsinchu County is a study of making the most out of an area's natural resources. Being close to the top of the island, it's fitting that Hsinchu County, or specifically Hsinchu City within it, is known for some of the highest level of technological developments in Taiwan. Why have some 360 high-tech companies flocked here to call Hsinchu its base of operations? Again, it's all down to the wide variety of natural resources here in the region. And one such vital resource here includes silicon. In today's society, silicon immediately brings to mind microprocessors, semiconductors, and circuitry for all our fancy modern-day gadgets. Okay, maybe breast implants come to mind as well. But there is a more basic material of which silicon is a vital ingredient, a material that can be simultaneously seen and unseen, that can enable people to see, that is capable of both sheltering us from the elements and containing the elements.
这馆是在1936年就到了11年的时候，是日本制作的一个绘画。政府有鉴于未来的发展，会议到平井，所以就将新竹玻璃产业从传统产业提升为现代的所谓工艺艺术，那就将这个行馆纳编，而且透过整体的一个规划，就变成我们今天的。
Notwithstanding the artwork on display here, the museum building itself has undergone several transformations to become what it is today. Originally a guesthouse and banquet hall for the upper echelons of Japanese society during their occupation of Taiwan, the building changed hands a number of times until its redesign and reopening in 1999.
我们今天看到的所有这些所谓的地冷工艺，就是用这样的一个概念。所以这个都是没有，就是已经用过的材料，然后我们把它分类做在处理，然后再把它表现成为一个意象，就视觉的一个传递。哇，其实就是蛮漂亮的，你可以把一个这个是玻璃经过分类以后把它打成碎粒，再利用美术概念，绘画的这种。 想法经过是成为一个图像。对啊，
好好看。对，再把它拼装起来。而且远远的完全感觉不出来那个是我们一般的那种玻璃。对，玻璃也就是说在资源回收再生使用以后，它从旧的也会变成新的。因为是经过高温的一个再度的一个萃取跟燃烧。对。An
interesting fact about glass. 10 kilograms of glass is 10 kilograms of glass. So if you recycle a bottle that's, say, 1 kilogram, you can make 1 kilogram of a new art piece. And that's what all these artists have done here. It's really, really cool taking something old and completely making it into something beautiful and new. I mean, you couldn't even tell that's old stuff.
Formed, recycled, and reformed. The sheer variety and complexity of the artwork on display here demonstrates that the permutations, shapes, and colors that can be created from glass is limited only by the imagination of the artist wielding and molding it. Art can be more than an aesthetically striking object. it can make a statement. And some of the glass pieces on display here are designed to do just that.
Let me out!
You know, they say living in one's own glass house is like living in a prison. Well, the Hsinchu Museum, they've taken a little bit too much, too literally. Everything is made out of glass, including the toilet. I better get out of here. I'm gonna break something.
Will I master the art of making mifun? Only if I stop eating it for a second. Glass artwork, intricate, colorful, beautiful in design, whether they are simple or complex. And what's great in the case of glass artwork is that in order to create your masterpiece, you're gonna have to blow stuff up. Literally. And visitors to the Municipal Glass Museum here in Hsinchu get to do just that. Visitors get to try their hand and mouth at the traditional glass shaping technique of glass blowing.
其实你要吹这个，其实你必须要有一点点勇敢呢。对，有一点勇敢。对，这样不用很多。OK。大概就可以吹出一个蛮大的气泡来。好，准备吹啦。OK，好。OK。好。我吹，好，对。 它现在是真空哦，我把它一弹，它就破掉了。Oh my god！这个就是它里面是真空。Yeah。Okay,
I think I've scared everybody in the room. Everybody's standing very, very far away from me. But the good thing about being in Hsinchu is that the sand here is silicon-based, and we have natural gas that comes straight from the ground. So, lots of opportunity to make mistakes.
新竹有产天然的气体。 就是瓦斯，那新竹也有一些细沙，那地理位置也比较适中，那才奠定了玻璃产业在新竹这个地方开展，那现在甚至要做到台湾本土的一个品牌，其实这个就是它在发展过程当中所碰撞出来的一些火花。啊，裂
开了！哦，Oh, how厉害！Oh my god, that is so cool.
新竹米粉，对。Oh
my god， 都是玻璃。哎，对，就用玻璃拉丝的方法。This is amazing. Oh my gosh, this is what you get from 38 years of glass blowing experience, and this is what you get from 38 minutes.
共玩。哎，对，是新竹共玩。
There's a food thing here. You know, it really amazes me that from this one thing here. I mean, this is a rod of just glass. It can be made into so many things, like, for example, a beautiful art piece. Even the chopsticks are made out of glass. And even the functional things, like, for example, contact lenses or TV. The reason why you can see us right now is because there's a piece of glass in your TV. So, really, glass is just an amazing, amazing thing. Oh, 真的很好吃，很想吃。哎，好，那就享用。 Yeah, the function of this piece of art right here is to make me hungry. Yup. Nothing like getting into the way of the heart of a city through its food. And I've got a bowl of mifen rice vermicelli, which is iconic here in Hsinchu City. They're very famous for rice vermicelli, mifen. I mean, not just that. I mean, they're famous also for gongwan soup, which is like meatball soup, ba zang ba wan. I mean, this list goes on and on. And as I'm saying it, there's saliva coming out of my mouth. The great thing about it is you don't have to go far and wide to look for these delicacies. You can just come here, the center of the city, Shen Huang Temple. So after you check out the temple here, so you're doing a little bit of sightseeing, you can enjoy their mifen. Mmm. So convenient and so delicious. Okay, so excuse me because I need to start my journey of Hsinchu, understanding Hsinchu culture.
I can't imagine a more fulfilling exploration of a culture than through its cuisine. Food ties families, friends, lovers, and communities together, weaving their pleasure of eating with national activities, religious events, and celebrations. The aroma, taste, and texture of the food of our origins soothe us into a familiar comfort zone, giving us a sense of identity. And one of the most iconic local delicacies in this windy city is mi fun, a Taiwanese rice noodle that gets preserved and dried swiftly with the help of the wind. Mi fun in Hsinchu is the equivalent of Gouda cheese in the Netherlands. So time to dive in, learn a century worth of secrets from the original mi fun masters.
These
things are easier to eat than to make. Just like the process of making pizza, we have to move fast or we burn the crust. Missing a step by even a few seconds could ruin the batter of rice noodles. I'm still working on the coordination part, but tasting what I'm making gives me fuel to continue this hard work. And this stuff tastes good raw too. Okay, focus, focus, focus. No room to mess up.
Our Hsinchu is famous for Hsinchu wind. The side part is to rely on wind.有风七分的风，然后三分呢是靠太阳晒，它很快的就干。它吹粉比较干，它所以它比较吃油一点，最好建议是用炒的。炒的话用筷子拌一拌，你的调味料全部煮熟了，米粉下去就 OK 了。
This is my third bowl of 米粉 here, which means I've already had four bowls of 米粉. I'm telling you, the quality of this homemade.The ingredients of it and the fact that, you know, I sweated into it just tastes so much better. One bite and it takes about 10 hours to make. Appreciation.
Up next, I get tied up, strung up, and stuck in some compromising positions. Right after the break.Fans of Captain Planet, he's a hero, or maybe X-Men, then you know that the weather, wind in particular, can be a very powerful force. A tool fit for superheroes, you might say. Even in the non-super-duper hero world, wind is a force that can be both a weapon of destruction in the form of uncontrolled typhoons, cyclones, and tornadoes, as well as a source for good when harnessed as a form of renewable energy via these wind turbines that you see all around Hsinchu.
So Don Quixote would have had a field day here in Hsinchu. I mean, look at all these wind turbines and windmills. So many dragons to fight. So obviously, they're not here just for aesthetic reasons or for your overly imaginative knight and squire. Mother Nature has given us so many resources. We've got the sun, and here in Hsinchu, we've got a lot of constant wind. We're just now learning how to tap that for green energy.
At some point in the history of this land, the aboriginals, explorers, or fishermen probably used these strong winds to sail, row, float, or get blown to Taiwan. Wind power is still vital to the people of Hsinchu, and though we aren't using it for transportation's sake, there are still plenty of people who are making every possible use of this wind.
Hey! I've just invented a new sport. We're gonna call it kite car surfing.So we've seen lots of the industrial use of the wind here in Hsinchu, but it can also be really fun when it's not trying to hit you in the face. This is Nanliao Park, and it is a great place to come for the weekend. I mean, usually it is filled to the brim with people who are here to kind of enjoy the open spaces and, like, you know, look at the boats and look at the ocean, and of course, look up and enjoy all the visually incredible things. I mean, how often can you see a squid like that in the air? And a panda bear, come on.Okay, so come on over. Take advantage of the wind. Let it flow through your hair and go kite car surfing.
Throughout history, people have found ways of entertaining themselves using what Mother Nature has provided. We've come up with all sorts of inventions, from low-risk activities such as flying a piece of fabric through the air to things that just sound insane at the outset, but then turn into regular activities or challenges for adventure seekers. Attaching a big rubber band to your leg and jumping off a bridge comes to mind, a la bungee jumping, which will always sound insane if you think about it. Anyways, here along the coast, you'll find more of those thrill seekers. In this case, people who wanted to go sailing but didn't necessarily want to get wet. Welcome to the world of land windsurfing, also known as landboarding. But as I'm about to learn, you won't stay much more dry here than if you had really gone sailing.
So,
for some reason, when it comes to me with sails, I just don't know what to do. It's like I have two left feet and two left arms. But we're gonna try it. We're gonna have fun today. The wind is very strong. You can tell by my hair, see, that we're gonna be going very, very fast. Hopefully fast in one direction and not fast, you know, toppling over, hopefully.
就是下出的时候，这个西南风呢，几乎这时候呢，全省很多地方呢都没有风，但是新竹这时候风是最棒的。但是时候呢，我们就玩风帆车，跟水上摩托车跟你飙机车的，跟或者说汽车的感觉完全不一样。它就是很顺的让你看着这个大地然后风很好的在带，但是它没有噪音，所以你会感觉到这种舒服不是一般那种有速度以外的可以享受的。
The wind scale here in Hsinchu goes from pretty windy to I just lost my hat windy to oh my god, that man just got blown off his scooter windy. Today's weather is closer to the oh my god side of the scale. Oh, that hurt.
I know you're never gonna sit in my car ever again, are you? Oh, I know.
One of the rarest luxuries on Earth is stretches and stretches of natural untouched land. Toss in dancing green trees and clear blue skies, and I've got the dream scenery for a cruise on my bike. 17 kilometers of seamless coastline and its surreal panoramic view of the timeless ocean confirm that Hsinchu is indeed a blend of heaven, earth, and human.
This is the perfect moment, standing right here, center of the universe, between the ocean, underneath the sky, and surrounded by this wind that comes from all around the world. And I've got 17 kilometers of it to enjoy on my bike. This goes on forever and ever, and I never want to go home. And I feel like I'm the only person in this whole world.
Spaciousness in a fertile environment is a perfect habitat for all living things. That's why this city, extending out to an area of over 1,000 hectares of Shangshan wetlands, is home of a very diverse population of wildlife, including 400 million fiddler crabs, different shellfish, and migratory birds. For such a simple city, a biodiversity farm like this wetland is a progressive attempt at Earth sustainability.
Zhang 大哥!
Hi!
大哥你好。你好你好。你好漂亮，好多空间哦。是，哎，这个地方的话，刚好是我们新竹的一个象山湿地。嗯。这个地方是我们台湾。 北台湾最大一个潮间带湿地，它总共有1600公顷。那我们等一下穿雨鞋下去，就是说，因为这里泥滩地常常会有一些会壳，那所以我们穿雨鞋下去就不会伤到你的脚。好，那现在准备好，哎，我们就出发，好不好？好。
象山湿地是北台湾最大一个潮间带湿地，它总面积有1600公顷。在这1600公顷的潮间带里面，涵养了许多的生物。我们这里的鸟类，全年你可以看到候鸟。
有将近273种，然后本身这里的螃蟹呢非常的多，然后螃蟹呢生的小朋友就是浮游性动物，那些浮游性动物就是鱼类幼鱼的一个食物，所以香山湿地呢，我的观察它是我们新竹鱼类的育婴房。
这边，
对，你蹲下这边，你看，哇，这边有一个洞，啊，这里，
是，我，他跟你
打疤痕，
真的，他很强，是不是
？OK，
哇，酷
，OK， 这个
，Oh my God， 我可以摸吗？
可以啊，哇，这个叫吸湿蛇，
吸湿蛇，它这个
就是它的
肉，它的舌头，
一般那个叫做它爬钻沙子用的，叫做腐殖。
Wow, look at this. This is beautiful. This is one of the many kinds of shellfish here in this wetland. And basically, this whole place is a wildlife preservation. It's like they have protected, the government here has protected the wildlife habitat here so that they can protect all these biodiversity that's going on here. So this is only one of many beautiful shellfishes. Isn't it so interesting that there's all this life going on here and we don't even know?But to continue protecting the wildlife here, I'm just going to put it back in so it doesn't die.
That 这个洞里面呢，躲的就有一只竹蛏。
竹蛏。
那什么叫竹蛏？我们叫它出来试试看。
好。
那这个我们不用挖。我们带了这个秘密武器。
秘密武器是糖，还盐。
一点盐巴，
盐巴，
那把盐巴放在这个洞口上来，
所以那个水太咸了，
太咸了，对，靠近有没有？
呀，
这样一抓
，Oh my God，Oh my God， 它进去了，
对，它进去了，
我撒一些盐巴，
不用，这样有没有
？Oh my God， 哦 ，Oh my God， 哇，它好长哦，
这样像不像一根竹子一节一样？
很像哎，
对，所以它叫做竹蛏。它是一个双壳的一种贝类，这是它钻地上的，所以你跟它放在这里面，
它会站起来这样进去。
对，
我好想看它这样子，它这样会吗？哇！
这个经济价值蛮高的。
对啊。
它口感蛮多的，可是现在香山湿地的话，这种因为环境上的污染，这个竹蛏慢慢变少了，所以我们来看看，抓出来看看就可以。
再放回去。
做研究了哈。
对。
剩下了我们还是要跟它放回去。
它回家。
对。
A moment of pratyahara, a yogic technique of withdrawal of senses, and hear the heartbeat of over 400 million little critters protected in their home. It's time to delve inland now and go deep into the mountains of Hsinchu, where the fresh water flows, plunges, and trickles into the ocean from its many waterfalls, rivers, and streams.Adventure seekers wanting to get away from the weekend beach crowds head away from the coast to seek out and explore the treasure trove of nooks and crannies on offer here. And of course, being adventure seekers, they look to explore those nooks and crannies via such unconventional means as possible. In this case, zip lines. Yep, zip lines. I'm heading to Jianshi Town to zip around like a bee on a mission.
那今天我们要来这边做活动。
OK， 好。
好，那你知道我们现在在哪里吗？
新竹。
好，我们这里是新竹县的尖石乡，我们在尖石乡的锦屏村。然后我们锦屏有个特色，就是我们这样看过去，我们这边有看到非常多的温泉。嗯。所以我们这边呢，大概会有五六家的民宿呢，都是做温泉。哦。然后我们这个民宿呢，比较特别的是，我们有户外活动、绳索活动。嗯。然后就比方说山训。OK， 我们一个来看。现在看到这个呢，是高空的滑降活动。我们从最高的地方滑到那边，到对岸，经过一个河船，高空的滑降活动。
它就是用滑下去。
对，滑降我们就穿一些装备。我们会穿一些装备。那新竹县尖石乡这边呢，它有很多第一个好山、好水、好地方。然后在这边呢，我们除了可以泡温泉，甚至我们可以去溯溪，然后做这个户外活动，让一些在都市的人们。在放假休闲的时候，可以来这边操作这些活动。在我的个人带团的经验里面人没有惧高症， 只有你对高音的高度适应症，今天三公尺我会怕，可是今天我就克服到五公尺、七公尺了。对，所以今天这些高公尺的活动呢，最主要是挑战自己，跟自己对话，你可以做到什么程度？放松。
That was
okay. You got
the most gracefulness thing I've ever done in my life. Oh my god, 我都晕了。Too much blood is going to my head. 哎呦，哦。为什么你弄得那么优雅，然后我是一个咚咚咚咚咚咚咚咚？
因为呢，我是教练，就这么简单。
Okay, let's not do that one more time because I am so dizzy right now.
The most difficult part of any adventure or new experience is the first moment where you have to take the plunge. I think most will agree, though, that if you somehow learn how to just let go, relax, and look around you, you'll find the process much more enjoyable. Again, I managed to make myself look like laundry hanging out to dry. Oh well, all the more time to enjoy the view, I guess. As in life, when you get stuck, you just have to pull yourself along until you finish.
Yeah, I got stuck. I know, I know. Does that mean I'm too heavy for this thing? Makes a nice chair, though.
Typical. Just when I'm getting comfortable, I get placed back on my feet, and in this case, back on the zip line. Zip lining and river tracing are great activities to try out in Hsinchu. So I say to all of you out there who are stuck indoors by their computers in the nearby technology district, come out here for some butt-whipping and sunshine. Just tell HR it's a team-building trip. And this contraption here would be a great place to string up your colleagues and coworkers.
Ooh! Woo! Okay, well, this is a good lesson of life. Sometimes you just have to know when to relax, take it easy, and know when to let go! Oh, hey, let's do that again. Okay, you ready? So, letting go.
Don't touch that dial as Nettie goes back in time and brings back some Broadway. Let's have an attitude of gratitude that nowadays we have such accessible transportation to travel almost anywhere in the world. I just had to hop on a train to arrive at Naiwan Station, and I didn't even have to think about it.But this train track was built for survival means over 50 years ago. The trains would carry timber back and forth from the mountains to the cities. Even though it's used for entertainment now, it still preserves a rustic feel of cargo train and its memories of the harder days.
Hi! 你好，我是 Nadia。
你好，你好，欢迎来到内湾。
哦，谢谢。今天天气非常好。
非常好。我们这个车站呢，已经非常有历史了哈。嗯。那这个。客家山城为什么会有车站？就是因为它内湾以前有两大产业，一个是林业，一个是矿业。嗯，那需要把这些煤矿啊、木材往外移，所以说会有这条火车。火车站前面这边就是老街，老街就包括客家山城的一些吃喝玩乐，客家美食都在老街上面可以看得到。
那我觉得要先体验。
OK， 那我们慢慢来体验。
好好好，
来，我带着你体验。
OK。
大家在内湾老街上可以看到很多漫画这些商品。哦，那我们也把内湾这条小山城也叫做漫画村。当然，内湾有它的人文，有它的历史，所以客家山城对于客家的一些美食、客家的一些文化，在内湾街上都可以。一个一个看得到，有一个非常特别的地方就是野姜花哦，野姜花可以在内湾到处都看得到。那野姜花呢，在内湾这个地方呢，把它发展成一个产业，野姜花的种植哦，还有野姜花的沐浴乳，所以说野姜花在内湾也形成了一个特色。
台湾最好吃的野姜花粽。
嗯，这也是它的什么叶子？野姜花的叶子，这个野姜花叶子去包的，这种很清香的，对。
嗯，所以这个是它跟一般的粽子不一样，
不一样的地方，对。
OK。
好，
谢谢。
尝尝看，
好香。
Delicious. The rice is super soft and chewy. Basically, I've been looking for an alternative for rice dumplings for the Dragon Boat Festival because glutinous rice sometimes can be a little bit fattening, but this is actually a healthier alternative. There's no oil. They don't add any MSG. It's completely natural from all the surroundings in Neiwan. Plus, it's with Yejianghua, which is super Neiwan local.
Now that I've eaten my way through the Neiwan Old Street, I'm ready to find out what is at the end of this yellow brick road. And here is where my soul's passion lies, movies! We all know movies are a global source of entertainment and craze as they convey stories through moving images, taking us away to escape land. Add in some nostalgia and throw in decorations of artifacts from the 1950s and voila, you've got a movie theater frozen in time.Entertainment is completely unrestricted by time and culture.
Wow! 好有味道的地方哦。
这戏院有60年历史了。那以前为什么会有这个戏院？其实内湾它有两大产业，一个矿业，一个林业。
那其实戏院最早之前呢，它是堆放木材的地方。
对啊。
那因为工人缺乏休闲娱乐的场地啊，所以把这边又改成戏院。内湾戏院这个大舞台是内湾戏院一个特色。那内湾戏院除了放电影之外，它这个大舞台其实在当地哦，以前可以客家大戏，
对啊，
还有演歌仔戏。其实他们村民哦，一个看戏聚集的一个地方。
I can smell the residual dust and hear the voices of all the characters that have played from decades past in this space. My performing cells starting to tingle to make some sort of imprint here. Lights, camera, action! Presenting my improvised solo piece, The Wait, by me. It started with a promise, so I waited. The sun went down, you were late.Then something broke. The clock, my heart, the promise. The end. I've got my Oscar speech prepared. Now that was just a glimpse of the genius that can be expressed through stage or film. Stories of passion, love, hate, revenge, death, and murder have been around for centuries as they portray the complexities of human nature. What better way to escape into someone's stories while enjoying a gourmet meal?
满桌全部都是客家菜，好香哦！
肚子饿了啊！
对，非常饿。我的印象中是我吃过客家菜，他们都是比较咸，还有一点点甜，是不是？
客家菜比较重口味啦，因为客家人的勤俭是大家都知道，所以说他的菜色会比较重口味，他比较下饭。
这是炸弹。
对，这是要这道菜叫炸弹开花，这是我们的创意料理。
好吃哦，甜甜的，
酸酸甜甜的，
对，它有那种像泰国那种酱。大哥，我知道这道菜是那个客家小炒，是不是？
对，客家小炒，
对，
道地的客家菜。
这我有吃过，因为好好吃，我好喜欢吃豆干。
是啊，
它这个酱很好哎。
豆干炒的干干的，香香的，非常棒。
Delicious homemade delicacies, classic entertainment, and good conversation, all so satiating.They should franchise this in every hot city because I'd like to do this every single day. That would be my perfect world.
Taboma, that means have you eaten yet in Hakka? I mean, how many places in the entire world can you basically watch oldie movies and eat Hakka gourmet food and just sit here and enjoy it in a movie theater? Not that many. This place is very special. And basically combine two things that I love, movies,I love movies so much. I can watch movies all day long. Food, I can eat every single day of lots of food. Combine it together in this amazing space with the Hakka culture. Yeah. Oh, by the way, maybe one day they'll play my movie here. And, you know, maybe in 2030. Yeah, and then, yeah. Okay, anyway, Come on, join us. Eat some Hakka food and... Oh, the movie's starting.
Coming up... after the break. As dawn breaks here in the Guanxi township of Hsinchu County, the sleeping giant is slowly coaxed out of her slumber by the encroaching shafts of daylight that pierce through her cave. As the day brightens upon the new day, the giant stumbles onto her giant feet and clumsily moves through her abode to the cave entrance, where she is able to survey the sheer scale of her kingdom. Yep, I must still be dreaming. Hakuna Matata!
There's a giraffe in my window.
Ah, good morning. No, we didn't go to sleep in Taiwan and wake up in the middle of Africa somewhere. That Mama Futa, that giraffe, is the one that woke me up this morning. But I forgive you because you're so cute. This is a cool themed resort now here in Taiwan where you can actually wake up next to giraffes and zebras and pelicans and all sorts of wild creatures. It's very, very cool.
They're so cute.
I am very fortunate that I have a job that allows me to fly around the world and travel to exotic places. But it's also really nice to know that Taiwan residents don't need to travel very far to experience something that truly feels different from day-to-day life on the island. Visiting this village and zoo resort here saves on hours of flights, tons of carbon, and you can do it on a weekend trip and not feel guilty about it. There's some irony in the fact that in their efforts to make your stay in this resort as memorable as possible, you're made to forget that you're in Taiwan.
去参加我们的那个密探动物园的行程。
OK， 好，
那我们出发咯。
Driving through the safari in a jeep is quite an experience. It's the opposite of a zoo, basically, where instead of walking around freely and examining the caged animals, it's you who are enclosed, albeit in a moving cage of glass, metal, and wheels, whilst the animals roam around the land free to examine you for a change. There's a certain part of me that gets nervous and excited about just how close the animals can get to you here. I must have checked the locks on these doors about 100 times while filming this segment.
Wow!
Oh my gosh!
I really feel like I've gone to Africa. Look at, oh my god, there's so many baboons. They're so cute. Oh my god, do you see the babies?
我们标榜的就是说与动物零距离嘛，所以你看，我们跟长颈鹿、跟犀牛都可以这么近距离的去跟它们喂食，这是多么的一个特殊的一个经验。其实这就是我们借由这些知识。我们不会用刻板的印象去教导小朋友，我们会用比较生动、比较口语化的方式去跟小朋友做互动。那小朋友最喜欢的莫过于就是看到那油猪在这么宽阔的地方跑上跑下。那像我们的黑天鹅或者鸵鸟，它有时候都会很跑来跑去，去跟你很近距离的贴着你的车窗，这种感觉真的很棒。
In Houston, one of my favorite activities to attend every year is the Livestock Show and Rodeo. It's there that we, as kids, were able to get up close with all the animals, pet them, and interact with them. Now, there's the petting zoo and there's the petting zoo. In Hsinchu, holding baby rabbits is no longer enough. Here, you get to play with the big kids.
Hi, you.
Okay. 把身高给他就可以了，对，你看。Wow.
Wow. Hi.
Oh my gosh.
Oh.
然后放低一点，对，你就可以摸得到，好。
Long necks, long eyelashes, and from what I have just discovered firsthand, long tongues. Have you seen the size of those things before? Wow. Standing underneath a giraffe and looking up at it, you really do start to feel a bit of an inferiority complex.
If giraffes weren't such genteel creatures, I'd be really afraid that he was gonna eat me right now. Oh my god, ow, that's my hair. Hi. He says hi.
He says hi. Get it? Hi, tall. Hi, hello. Now, for a completely different kind of hi, we head just the next door over for the theme park section of the resort, where one can get a more concentrated adrenaline kick with the thrilling rides on offer. But with all this big talk about the scary rides, I go and opt for something a little more sedate. Merry-go-round, anybody?
Amusement parks too. I mean, it's the only place where you can scream your head off, eat a whole bunch of kiddie snacks, hug a ginormous teddy bear, and even throw up in non-alcoholic related instances and not feel completely embarrassed. There's a little bit of kid in all of us. Yeah.
Oh, the choices. Now, should I start with the Turkish ice cream cone, or should I wait until after I flip myself around 90, 180, 360 degrees? It doesn't matter how old you are. Theme parks like these are designed to drag the kid back out of ya. But as I prepare to strap myself in for this ride, I begin to feel that maybe, just maybe, I've bitten off more than I can chew.
I'm just kidding, I'm not scared. We're not scared, are we? 我们不怕吗？不怕，完全不怕。 Not only that, these seats are perfect. They fit really nicely. And it has a nice little scoop in it just in case there's a little accident later.
I actually just got dizzy again watching that footage. These kids are like Energizer bunnies. They just go on and on and on and on. Oh God, saying that is making me want to throw up again.
I know exactly how you feel. I mean, I thought it was a tough cookie. We go jump off waterfalls, we even climb Jade Mountain, but I've got nothing on these kids, man. Help me! Save me! Bye!